The divide between Israeli and diaspora Jewry seems to be growing, and some theorize that it's because reform and conservative movements are adopting extremist ideologies. Well, here to discuss is former chairman of the U.S. Democratic Party in Israel, Sheldon Schorer, legal advisor to the Israeli Movement for Governability and Democracy, attorney Simcha Rothman, lecturer on public policy from Haifa University, Hezi Kugler, and Natan Nestel, who is investigating the campaign to alienate American Jews from Israel. Thank you all for joining us. Now, why are we seeing reports of less American Jews supporting the state of Israel? Let's begin with that issue.
You know, Natasha, I think that there's a divide between Israel and Jewry in the United States because Israel drives away, to a very great extent, Jews who don't live here. Israel is also important to many Jews who live outside of Israel. But if Israel is going to focus from a religious point of view, on orthodoxy and the strict tenets of orthodoxy and halakhic Judaism, to the exclusion of other large segments of the Jewish world, particularly from North America, then this naturally alienates them.
So you see this as kind of a religious conflict. What are some other takes here?
Well, I'll tell you, the question of why is really important, and we don't know the answer. Most of the articles and or things that people are talking about, recognizing the phenomenon, saying something is happening. Why it's happening, I don't know. I know for a fact that on July 9th this year, they'll be starting a serious study to try to find out exactly what is the engine that's driving this thing. Why are people feeling this way? One thing I can suggest is intersectionality. That is to say, people no longer deal in grays. People are moving very polarized, either one way or the other. Mm-hmm. So, and it, everything sort of fits in. Well, so if you're a liberal Jew, you're anti-Trump, and Trump is pro-Israel, so therefore you're anti-Israel. You're pro-America, I'm an American first, so therefore the feeling of Judaism, Jews as a family, is less.
Well, you know, the Israeli government has pointed to the fact that there are several Jewish organizations that are you know, coming to the forefront of, I guess, the Israeli-Palestinian conflict and are essentially anti-Israel. Let's talk a little bit about those organizations.
I think that that's exactly the point. I think for many, many Jews in the U.S., especially from the left or the radical left in the U.S., being Jewish has no positive context. What does it mean to be Jewish? It's to be against whatever the Christian right believes, basically. And if the Christian right supports Israel, then I'm against Israel. If the Christian right are against our LGBTQ rights, then I am for LGBTQ rights. If abortion, there is no Jewish issue that the radical left Jewry in U.S. Goes for. And that's alienate the Jews in Israel against them, because basically you're anti-Israel. That's what makes you a Jew, and you are and it goes both ways.
What is your take?
Sheldon spoke about the phenomena and the engine, and I've been focusing on the engine. And exactly, you're right. We have to understand where it's coming from, and there is a campaign by several Jewish groups which are focusing on American Jewry, especially on the young generation, and turning them against Israel. You know, everybody knows about, or many people know about J Street, which has been presenting itself as pro-Israel. But, we spoke before, or the article that we saw is about Simon Zimmerman. I mean, looking at Simon Zimmerman is a very good way to understand the process. The young generation has been targeted by J Street and other groups like the New Israel Fund, Trua, Ben's Ark. All of them, by the way, are source-supported groups. And they've been very cleverly manipulated, the young generation. I mean, they are being presented by those groups by several events which portrays IDF as an army which commits war crime. For example, they bring often, J Street brings often to the campuses, they bring breaking the silence, and they present. And
well, the question here is though, why? If it is organizations like this that are part of this problem, why are perhaps Jewish, you know, campus communities bringing these organizations in. How is it that we're seeing this kind of willingness?
They're filling a vacuum. You know, when people come on Aliyah from other areas where Jews have problems or they encounter anti-Semitism, to come here because we're the solution to their problem. In North America, that's not the issue. For North Americans, like, for example, myself, we came on Aliyah, we go on Aliyah because Israel is an inspiration to us. And so the problems that we have in Israel aren't really the issue that pushes them away. Israel needs to serve as a beacon, needs to serve as an example, needs to inspire people to come live here. Israel continues to be an embattled country. All those old messages continue to hold true. But when Israel again pushes away and paints itself into a corner and puts itself into a narrow corner of, including of American politics, by nature, it alienates a large segment of the Jewish community. And as a result, you're going to see some of the fringe. You'll see some of the fringe become more radical as well.
So those are processes that we're talking about. We're talking about processes of tens of years. You can't blame the last two years of Israeli politics and Trump and the first Obama
politics. For years, Israeli government has been caving. Israeli government has been caving into.
And Netanyahu came to the, when Obama was in power, Netanyahu came by the invitation of both Democrats and Republicans to the U.S. Senate. It's a Congress. It's very easy to blame. What you said was correct. You said it's filling a vacuum. There is a vacuum, and the vacuum is, what does being a Jew mean?
And that vacuum is being filled, it only will be filled by hatred. Yeah.
So that leads us to our next question here. I guess, you know, what can be done to change the division that we're seeing here?
Okay.
I was just looking at the phenomenon. I'm thinking 50 years ago, right after the Six-Day War, there was an unbelievable onrush, a connection between Israel and American Jewry, that being Jewish meant something, that it was one big family. And when Israel was in trouble, American Jewry responded both with their bodies and with a lot of money to help assist. There was this feeling, and of course, after the victory, there was this gush. Mm-hmm. Everyone, it was a lovey thing, and there was a strong connection. That is basically gone. What's happened is that the American Jewish community, largely liberal Jews, reform conservative, more reform, largely liberal, don't feel that family relationship anymore. Mm-hmm. Quite the opposite. They feel that they're Americans first. Being Jewish doesn't mean that we're part of a people. Being Jewish means tikkun olam. It means social activism. It means being a good guy and being nice. Being Jewish doesn't mean that much. Mm-hmm. And being Israeli, it's not important.
The discussion for our next interview is going to be how we change this division. Thank you all so much for joining us.
Thank you.